Hi, Dominic D here, and welcome to another Fallout 4 video. Today we are at the Finch Farm, where I have built a pretty cool settlement consisting of these train carts, as you know. You know I like these a lot. And what I've done is I've suspended them from underneath this highway pass here, so I think it looks pretty cool. I'm just gonna fly about a little bit here and show you guys real quick what this looks like from above. Afterwards, I'm going to walk you through it, of course, as usual. So what makes this a little bit unique, I think, is these cards suspended from here. We even have some pathways here. It don't look too safe, but that's kind of part of the idea, part of the charm, right? So yeah. We even have a bus over here, hanging. That has been used for some sort of home, some sort of accommodation. And we have the lower levels down here on the ground floor, which is protected by a wall. And we have a lot of guards all over the place. So the idea is for it to be sort of a raider settlement, a raider trading station of some sort. There's not too many homes in here, not too many beds, but it does have a lot of shops and a lot of interesting areas. So let's just start from the beginning here. Let me just toggle the UI back on and collision back on. I am gonna toggle God mode on just to be safe, because there's a lot of places that you can fall down here. It's a little bit dangerous. Okay, so coming down this way, this is pretty much the main entrance. We have a guard here.
Yes.
In a raider outfit. She looks pretty terrifying. On our right here, what we've passed is sort of the farming area. This is covered by these, whatever they are, to provide some shade for the workers here working at the farm. I guess it kind of doesn't make too much sense to block the sun off from the crops, but oh well. I thought it looked kind of cool. So anyway, we got another guard over here, keeping a lookout in this direction. As you can see, we do have some super mutants here as our neighbors. But they don't seem to cause too much trouble. As long as we stick to our area here, they seem to stick to theirs. So the main entrance here, we do have some raider style things. These look pretty nasty, so you can't just crush in here with a vehicle or something. Note the signs as well. Residents only.
Yeah.
Guess it doesn't make too much sense if it's a trading station, but oh well. We have a little bit of a welcome area here. I guess you might be registered, get registered here. Maybe the guard will take a photo of you as well. The guard who left his keys for grabs here. Not very smart. Okay, so there's a little bit of a seating area here. I think I'm gonna start by just walking down this way along the wall. Let me actually just toggle walk on. So just a little bit of a sleeping area here. I guess it's for the guard on duty watching the gate here. Maybe there'll be two at once, so they can take turns having a rest and stuff. Also, please note that this time I've put in a little more effort into filling this stuff up with clutter. Using the OCDecorator, yeah, which allows you to place like clutter items such as this cat ball, for instance, and once it's placed, it cannot be picked up. It's just static. It's there permanently. Well, you can remove it, of course, in the workshop mode, but you probably know this stuff, right? We got these oil lamps that are really cool. It's swaying the wind just a little bit. sleeping area here. He's got some towels under here and an alarm clock. Mr. Pebbles, first cat in space. It's a little bit of a ham radio. There's a ham radio here. You got some of these tapes lying about as well. Some more sleeping area down here. And there should be a guard keeping a lookout here. I guess he's, well, he is on patrol. So let's walk down this way and go up to the right here. It did turn a little bit, became a little bit foggy now. But hopefully it will be able to see stuff still. So yeah, these are sort of the guard quarters, the barracks. Elevated above the city. We got this really cool hanging car. For whatever reason, I can't seem to figure out a good reason why you would stuff that in there, but it looks cool. I'll show you that from downstairs as well afterwards. There's some sleeping area here. A little bit of, is that a pouch or something? Caps. Their bags here. Foot lockers. We got a siren here that you can turn on to call in the settlers. Actually, let me just do a sleep real quick, just to see if this doesn't clear up a little bit. All right, here we are. I just fast forwarded one day so we could get a little bit better weather here. This is early morning right now. As you can see, and as you probably know, the Finch Farm area is also located by the water. I'll show you that in a sec. So it has pretty good water access here. So anyway, as I was saying, this is a siren that you can call, that the guards can use to alarm the other settlers here in case of an attack. So, ammo box here. The car that is hanging for some reason. I don't know, I just liked it. Some more beds here. Cup of coffee, nice. I could actually go for some coffee right now. I have some posters that are lighted. And we got some guards on duty here.
People are having to sleep in shifts.
Yeah, I know.
It's making everyone.
I know. I'm missing some beds here, as you can probably hear from this guy complaining. So he's got the pretty cool raider outfit going here. Looks pretty nasty. All the guards also have
scraps, a hobby of mine. You probably saw the pile by the house.
Yeah, that's Abraham Finch, so he has some unique dialogue. One of the guys living here when you find the place. I don't know if you know the quest line, you can help him out and help save his, I think it's his son. So yeah, anyways, as I was saying, these guys are keeping a lookout from up here. They have rifles, scoped rifles as well. And can run in here and sound the sirens, the alarm here if necessary. So let's head on down here. So if you're just visiting this place, or if you have no business in the guarding area, the barracks here, I guess you'll just pass through here. Of course, by the way, these are closable, so you can lock down the whole thing. Passing through here, we enter the main area, and this is the original building of the Finch Farm. You probably know this. I haven't done too much about that, so I'm just gonna peek in here real quick. Beds cannot be removed for some reason from this area, but it's okay. It's just a place to hang out, I guess. So we got the courtyard here. Hello? As you can see, the hanging vehicle up there. Got an oil lamp hanging from it as well. Kinda looks cool. The farming area here, underneath the barracks. Provide enough food for the entire settlement and to allow for some trading as well. So, passing through the area here, the farm area. We'll see the no waste utility shop here. So So this is just a utility shop. Has a lot of stuff stored here. All kinds of different stuff that you might need.
Yeah.
So yeah. A lot of different stuff. And as I said, I've used the... Okay, that's not intended. But anyway, I've used the OCDecorator to fill this up with some stuff here. We even got jangles in the corner. Alright. Right next to it, we have the sharp dagger. And as you can see, the barber here also has a sign up here. So you can see it from the entire settlement. So it's down this way. This is actually probably the laziest one, because I haven't really put anything in here yet. We do have a little bit of a surgical area here.
I got some goods I can sell.
I guess the barber also functions as sort of a doctor here in the wasteland. We got the barber chairs here. That's pretty much it. Daniel Finch is the only one without a raider suit at the moment. He's keeping a lookout here. It's actually a pretty nice view. Sort of beach here. Waterfront. If you had a boat, be easy access. Alright, let's head back in here. So, across the farm yet again. I do want to show you the other side here real quick.
Yes.
So this is the outdoor area here. We just have some storage underneath these carts. What are they called even? I can't remember. But it's just some storage area out here. Let me just see real quick. It's just called box cars. Yeah, okay. So the box cars. So we have the traveling doctor here.
Out there. Good thing too. Otherwise no business for doctors, am I right?
Yep. So he can still enter through here. I'm not sure if he's entering through the main entrance here. There's another back entrance I'll show you in just a sec. So these were the guard quarters here. And the guard is actually here now. And right here. This guy's being punished for something. Probably stealing or something. I guess. Doesn't look very pleasant. Sort of the middle of the whole thing. I guess this will be done in sort of an official manner. Yes. People would gather here in the settlement to have a look. The settlement officials, whatever, leader of the settlement, would make an announcement.
Hey, at least it's honest work.
About this guy's bad deeds and whatnot. So, yeah. It's going on right here in the middle. So here we have a gun shop. And a cow desperately trying to push its way inside the settlement here. the gun shop here, we have a raider keeping a lookout in this direction also. You can see we have gunners on this side. It's a pretty dangerous area. Alright, so the weapon shop here. You can see we have weapons on the wall. Combat rifle, deathclaw gauntlets, charged power fist, some pistols, display case with some bobbleheads here. Armor racks that doesn't have anything actually. That's actually just because I forgot. Some cool stuff in here as well. Some armor racks here. Some typical wasteland gear right here. And by the end here, we just have a little bit of a sleeping area. I guess the guy working in here in the gun shop. Moving down this way, and the cow has managed to get inside the car now. What is it doing? Right, anyways, ignore that, guys. We have the elevator, and this will take us up to the upper levels here. I think I'm actually going to take it down instead, but let's we'll get to that in a sec. But this is the back entrance with a really noisy cow. As you can see, I've stacked some cars. to provide some cover. So they sort of work, function as an extension of the wall. We have a tower here, there's a minigun up here. Could be mounted by a guard in case the settlement is attacked. And there's a little bit of a turret here, but otherwise just an entrance right here. We actually have Nick walking about right there. And there's the fisherman's store, the fresh fish store. And it's obviously by the coastline here. She's selling some fish, I guess. No, also, alcoholic fits. Beverages, obviously. Sleeping
running
area.
Farm sure makes for a full day.
Fish in the back here. All right, here we go. The Wonderwear store.
Yeah.
Obviously, these are more regular clothes, not armor exactly, but the sort of stuff you'd wear on more of an everyday basis.
Huh?
The counter here. A little bit of stuff lying about. Some nice casual. It's actually pretty cool. Office. This guy is even. Yeah, has a cane as well. Some nice hats. And this isn't supposed to be open, but they tend to open it anyways, the settlers. Which is a sleeping area for the store owner here. In the back. Alright, so here in the middle of everything we have the bar or the restaurant, so there's two entrances to this. I did start with only one entrance, but the settlers couldn't figure out how to get here. I guess the barkeep is left for now. We got a lot of stuff lying around here. People can come here, have a bite to eat, and a bit to drink. It's a pretty decent sized kitchen here. So let's just, she's standing in the way, so let's head down this way again. Okay, so coming through here, I think we've seen pretty much all there is to see down here. So this
hope
is sort of the back,
since.
Or another, another back entrance here. And a guard in a raider outfit keeping a lookout. Even have a little bit of turret here. See this from the other side here. Of course we also have stuff on the top floor here. This is sort of a marketplace, and what we have up here are the generals, like the leaders, the gang leader, whatever, settlement officials quarters. I'll show you that by the end. And it's actually really cool. We have sort of a special way to enter it, I guess you could say. It's pretty cool, so stay tuned for that. So here's a ramp going up to the suspended part of the settlement. We have a guy with his store here. General store, a lot of different stuff. Sells clocks, obviously. Magazines, toys, whatever. A lot of different stuff. And a little bit of a seating area here.
People are having to sleep.
He's even suspended some stuff here just for extra space. So this is just hanging from the bridge up there. In the back here we have more sleeping quarters, and here's the exit. As you can see, it's off limits right now, but this is the suspended bus. Someone used to live there. But it's sort of begun falling down, so they've put this stuff up to keep people from going there. But as you can see, you can actually still enter it. Pretty cool, I think. Hanging from up here. Alright. So, you cross here. Oh, by the way, as you probably noticed, a lot of this stuff is sort of slanted. I finally figured out, I don't know, just, you know, on the count of me being stupid, I guess, figured out that the place everywhere mod allows you to tilt items. So that's a really cool feature and something I've used a lot here to make it seem a little less plain, a little more alive, like it's actually hanging. So you can see this, the floor here, slanted a little bit. There's a Nuka-Cola machine here. This is the top of the elevator. We can take that one down later, perhaps. There's a sleeping area here. Go across from here. Yeah. There's a guy keeping a lookout from up here. Also a really nice view of the ground floor of the settlement. There's a boxcar hanging here, I guess this, I'm not sure what happened here, but they don't seem too safe, right? That's the idea. Oh, by the way, I almost skipped this part right here. There's some hanging pathways here as well. This had a bank sign on the outside. I don't know if you notice. The settlers can't get here, unfortunately. It's a little too complicated to walk on this stuff, I guess. but it's just, yeah. This. Not too much stuff going on here. Yeah, so let's head across this bridge that's almost falling apart. There's a little bit of a nice dining area here. I don't know if you noticed, but it has a bar sign on the outside here. You can walk across from here. We have the detective over here, which I haven't added, to be honest. I would have to tilt everything I put in there, and I just couldn't be bothered right now. So that's for a future video, guys. But it's, as you can see, it's a hanging sort of container. It looks pretty cool. Everything here is hanging, suspended with these wires. It's kind of cool, I think. So moving through this dining area here, we enter this suspended pathway, bridge, whatever here, these stairs. And we can enter the top floor on top of the highway overpass. And this is pretty much a trading area. So, walking through here, we have a lot of different traders. There's a clothing station right here.
Huh? Yes?
There's a lot of nice stuff lying about here. These are the immersive vendors from the immersive vendors mod. They look pretty cool. Good, I think. Yeah, so let's go to the right here first. We got a dining area here as well. A lot of stuff back here. There's a guy with a bar.
Things are a bit crowded. A few more beds would lift everyone's spirit.
Guess he's cooking some food here on top of this little fire here. Some cages for animals, I guess. A little bit of a farming area up here. And in the back, we got the best view of the settlement, I guess. You can sit down here, enjoy the view. Put on your binoculars. Look at what the super mutants are doing. So just an amazing view from here. A really nice area. A little bit more.
Seems to be growing well.
Of a food area. A general store here. A lot of crap lying about here. I love these immersive vendors. They're pretty cool. All this other crap I placed using the OCDecorator. It's funny how these they walk into the ground when they use them. It's kind of weird. But anyway, yeah. So this is the marketplace on top of everything. And as you can see, there's a lot of people here, and they can actually access it, which is pretty cool. A guns vendor, obviously. Chems.
I can patch you up if you
weapons
need.
Workbench here in the back. Feet, and an armor station here. go selling ice cream, I guess. Alright. So that is pretty much it, guys. Yes. So the final thing to show you is... I wrote big boss up here, because these are the headquarters. It doesn't look too safe, but I think it's kind of cool. He has some windmills on top. A windmill hanging from the bottom here, providing power. Yeah, a satellite dish or something up there. And the way you enter this, and this is the coolest part, is using this crane right here. As you can see, it has a pathway here that you can walk up, and activating it lowers the bridge. There we go. So now we can walk up here and walk up the bridge. And we're at the general's quarters here. And I can lower it again, but if I do, I can't reach it, so it's gonna be hard to bring it back up here. So yeah, the quarters up here, just a really nice area, nice place to hang out. It does have a radio. I guess it makes use of the satellite dishes on the roof. A toilet, and the only shower in the entire settlement. I don't know how they pump the water up here, but well. there's a balcony here with an amazing view. Yeah, so it's not a bad place. I guess there's some perks to being the boss in this raider settlement here. Sleeping area. So that is pretty much it, guys. I love this bridge here. It's a really, really cool thing. And even though I've had it available for a while, I think it's the... What mod is it? It is the SOE pack, I believe. I haven't figured out how to use it before, what to use it for, so it looks pretty cool. Alright guys, so I did want to share this at nighttime also, because I have put a little bit of thought into the lighting. It does have some pretty cool signs here and there as well. And it does seem a bit more atmospheric at night, so let's just do another quick little walkthrough just to see what it looks like at night. So I've toggled collision off real quick so I can show you guys. As you can see, a lot of the stuff lights up. The entire settlement have these projectors. Is that what it's called? Whatever, these lights to illuminate the outside. For some reason, this is not active. I wonder if that has to do with my collision. No. So yeah, a lot of these lights going all the way around the settlement. As you can see. So the guards should be able to spot anyone creeping up on the settlement. We have these hanging lights as well inside. From the suspended parts.
Lost track of how many blisters I got.
The signs do look a little bit better at nighttime. They pop a little more. Other than that, as always, I have used mostly these more atmospheric lights. It's mostly oil lamps.
You should know.
That illuminate the buildings from the inside. So yeah. Just show you the elevator as well. I think it did promise that. So the second and third floor isn't here. It only takes you from first to fourth, and that is right here. So yeah. Collision back off again. Some colored lights here. And moving up to the market.
Yes.
We do have a lot of these lanterns as well. Oil lamps. Whoops.
Yes?
Alright guys, so that is it. I want to thank you so much for watching this video, and if you enjoyed it, please subscribe to the channel. And leave a like on the video as well, that would help me out a great deal. So thank you guys, I will see you in the next video.